So there I was, in a dark room with a stiff body. I'd exhausted all the leads that the maid could give me. I'd asked everyone around town, and all the clues pointed to that one guy. That one guy at the council club, but everybody else said it wasn't him. He said it wasn't him. It appeared the case was stopped in its tracks. Dun dun dun.
Okay, yeah, for real though. I've actually been... Oh, hello and welcome back to A Wandering Orc Plays Morrowind. I have been asking everybody around town about this guy and the murderer's description and everything. They do all tell me the same thing. They're like, go to the council club and look at that one Dunmer in all of the town with the red hair. And then I go to him and he's like, hey, it wasn't me. It was probably Nine Toes. And then I ask some other Argonian and he's like, couldn't be Nine Toes. He's just not the murderer. So yeah, there's definitely like some racism going on here. You may notice that Raylan Halalu has... some extravagant clothes on, my goodness. I am using him now as my perma chest, sort of my body to store all the clothes. So you have to think he like stacks up, like he's got like 16 stacks of clothes on right now. He's a very warm body. I'm just trying to keep him preserved or something. It was actually the Murderherm's idea. I appreciate that because I am running out of places in my house to put clothing. So yeah, the stiff is looking good. I checked under all the pillows in the house because
of the
gamble buddy
back
in the day. This lady's just acting all nonchalant, like nothing even happened. So yeah, her pillow yielded nothing. At least I have her key now if I ever need to get back in the house. And I can't walk over him. I always have to walk around his dead body. So what are we doing today? You know what? First we have to go donate that gold that we took from the stiff's house. We gotta go donate it, because we said that we would. I believe it was 5 gold. So let's just... We'll just do that then, shall we? Alright. And I'm gonna do it, like, in little singles here, because I feel like it's only right. Otherwise, it looks really weird. They have to know that it's 5 gold. Alright, just a couple more here. Alright, I don't know where that last one went. Oops, I think I dropped it at my feet. Okay, so there was like a wayward piece of gold. I guess I'll move it. I can't just like leave it there. So the other thing that I think we're gonna do today is probably head over to Fort Moonmoth because, ooh, wow. Oh my god. Oh. It's floating! It's holy! It is the holy gold. We shall kneel before it. Oh, so that's it. We have donated to the tribunal, praise Om Sivi, and all that stuff. So I've actually been looking into the houses a little bit more. First off, let's bring Moonmoth up, because we do have that quest. Looks like there's some corrupt officials and there's somebody there who really wants to talk to me about it. So let's see, where is Moonmoth again? Oh, it is. Oh, I remember. I always accidentally go there. It was like I was going to Pelagiod, and I think it's over here. So yes. So I have been looking a little bit more into the houses and deciding which one I might want to visit. So I'm a little caught up on, it's a hard choice, right? So Redoran is like incredibly pious. So I thought that might be a really good pick, you know? I mean, we just went on this whole pilgrimage and we're super holy now. I mean, I don't think anyone can dispute our crazy holiness. I mean, oh my god. You see that man? Or woman? Oh my god. Living the life. Wow, amazing. See, this is why it would suck to be a Netch. Look at that. He's not getting out of that anytime soon. Oh boy. So yes, so back to it. So House Redoran is incredibly pious, right? But then I got stuck on the definition of the Telvanni being wizard lords. That is just way too badass. Hey, are
Whatever
you,
Whatever it is, I'm not interested.
Yeah, I'm not either, buddy. I ain't interested in what you're selling. So yeah, wizard lord is kind of like an awesome title, and I might actually
Let's hear it.
But nah, I got nothing for you, pal.
Anytime now.
The person that I'm looking for here, let's check it out. Okay, so not so nonchalant. There's a rumor that the Legion champion Larius Varro over at Fort Moonmoth wants to talk to me about an unspecified subject. And this was heard from the woman who secretly goes to my roof when I'm not looking. Or at least when she thinks that I'm not looking, so I know it must be true. She seems like a really shady individual. She would know this kind of thing. But over here, I was told that the Legion champion Larius Varro over at Fort Moonmoth has sworn an oath to stop corruption, but the syndicates have got their people protected. To fulfill this oath, it seems like Varro may have to work outside the system, and that's what we heard last time. So here we are. We need to find, oh my god, I already forgot his name. Larius Varro is who we're looking for, so let's see if we can't find Larius Varro. You? No, I'm Marie. No, excuse me, is Mr. Varro available? Mr. Rad Hardheart.
Say something or move on.
I don't have words for you, actually. His name is Rad. Rad Hardheart. No, Irfing. What the Irfing crap? Nope.
Hurry this up, will
Paragon.
You?
He's a Paragon of Wood Elf Justice. Hey, excuse me. Could I please lay member? Abolitionists?
I've heard of a secret organization called the Twin Lamps. It helps runaway slaves escape. It's against the law to aid runaway slaves, but I think slavery is wrong, and I can understand why these abolitionists would want to break the law.
Yeah, buddy, me too. Can I ask you about the Blades?
The Blades are the Emperor's spies. They're everywhere, but no one knows who they are.
Okay, lay member.
We accept all citizens of good character and earnest faith. We only ask a one-time pledge of 50 drakes to aid us in our good works. To become a lay member of the Imperial Cult, speak with Ifka at Fort Pelagiod, Solorius Cerulius at Fort Bookmoth, Samutis Vonus at Fort Moonmoth, Ruchia Conision at Grand Council Chambers in Ebonheart, or Lalatia Varian at the Imperial Chapels at Ebonheart.
Okay, thanks, buddy. Okay, so hey, we did actually find something interesting from Mr. Paragon, and that is that the Twin Lamps is apparently an organization which I have not heard of before that helps runaway slaves escape. I would love to find them. Now I've heard of the Twin Lamps. I wonder if I can find more information on them. That would be really cool. Because Annalie has actually helped quite a few slaves escape.
Let's hear it.
In the path of her ventures. Oh my god. See, that's just a steel dagger, but it looks so badass, it could totally fool me. Alright. Is it Samutis Vunis? No. He is also not who we're trying to talk to. So let's check out some other rooms here. Oh no, he's probably not in the prison towers, right? I mean, unless he likes to hang out with all the people that he's put in prison, which could is a little bit weird, but I mean, to each their own, I suppose. I'm not here to judge. Damn it, I could get lost anywhere. I really could. Here we go. Ah, alright. So let's try the other side and see if we can't find him.
Hurry this up, will you?
Oh my god, did we just totally went in a circle. Never mind. We'll give this another try then, shall we? Ooh, is there something back here? Oh my god. Are these all the, like the constellations or something?
Now, where did I put that?
It's gotta be around here somewhere,
Let's
right?
Let's hear it.
See outside? Maybe it's this guy without a helmet. Maybe I walked right by him and just didn't even pay any attention.
Time
no, he's just a guard. Is it Fort Moonmoth? Do you remember that? Oh my god, his shadow. Oh my god, that's weird. I don't remember that happening before. It might just be some new thing happening with my graphics card or something. Fort Moonmoth. That's where I am, right? Is this Fort Moonmoth? Well, it's Moonmoth Legion
Let's
Fort.
Hear it.
That's close enough, I suppose. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, buddy. Alright. Let's get our Levitate on. We're gonna go straight to the top. We've done this before. Remember all that Telvanni crap? Oh, nobody's up here. Well then. Ooh, look at this guy! Hey, I wonder if I'm gonna, like, aggro him.
Hey, buddy. Can't get me, can you? There's a wall here. Woo!
Oh, I'm stuck on something. Oh, gee! Oh, no! Are you after him? Oh, god, yes! Aerial view! Oh my god! It's perfect! Oh, dude, that guy's gonna kill you! You can't even attack it! Oh! Oh no! We're not gonna help him though. Oh shit, it can attack me too! Oh my god, it's coming over! Maybe if I can lure it over, then this guy, then I can help this guy out. Come on, buddy! Come on, you can get- Oh my god, I can't believe he's hitting me. Seriously, this is outrageous. Yes! He pulled out the bow! Oh, this is great! We need a better view. We need a better view. Let's get our aerial view. Oh my god, he killed it! We missed it. Aw. Well, that's okay. That was pretty bad. You're a hero, buddy. You're a hero. Alright, so, wow. That was cool. He says nonchalantly as I float above his head. Alright, so we got a trapdoor up here, some cliff racers, a nice view of Dwemer ruins. Look, I'm gonna find this guy eventually. He cannot evade me forever. Oh my god. He was right at the bottom of these steps. I can't believe it.
At least
we found him. Dude, you have no idea how hard you are to find. I mean, you shouldn't be, but you are. So, greetings, Laris Vero. And I bow in my robes and I look entirely pious. Alright, Laris Vero.
I'm Laris Vero, Legion Champion of Fort Moonmoth. I've been hoping you might come by. I have work for you, if you're interested.
I am, as a matter of fact. He's got those piercing eyes. Alright.
Through various channels, I've learned a bit about your situation. I'd like to tell you a little story, and when I'm done, you can ask me some questions, and then, maybe, you might decide to go out and do some things. You might not. That's your affair. And I also want to tell you about a nice present I think the Emperor wants you to have. I'm not sure where it is, but maybe you'll want to check back and see if I've found it later, after you've done some things.
Okay, dude, you are not being very suave, but I totally get it. So he's trying to work within the law, but outside of the law. He doesn't want to admit that he's actually trying to hire me on to be like a merc or something. But yeah, so let's hear your little story.
Once upon a time, there was a bad magistrate who took gold from criminal organizations to reduce the sentences and fines of criminals. Everybody knew he was doing this, but nobody could prove it, because if it could be proved, the bad magistrate had important friends. And proof is not as powerful as important friends. Tell me more, Larius Vero. At the same time, there was a good officer who enforced the laws because he thought laws made people happy and safe. And it bothered the good officer that enforcing the laws did no good because the bad magistrate let the criminals go as quick as the officer caught them.
Oh, this is a really good story.
For a long time, the good officer sighed and said, "What can I do? Because the bad magistrate has important friends and nothing I can do will touch him." But then the good officer said, "Say, wait a minute. What about the bad people who are bribing the bad magistrate? They haven't got important friends, and if they aren't around, the bad magistrate can't get any more bribes."
Okay.
And even better, the good officer suspected that the bad people who were bribing the bad magistrate were probably criminals themselves. So the good officer decided that it would be good if the bad people, I imagine he's like winking, who were bribing the bad magistrate should go away. Forever.
Where are they gonna go, Larius Vero?
So that good officer made a special little prayer that there would be a little bloodbath to wash the bad people away. Isn't that a nice little story? Maybe not the perfect story, but it ends with a prayer and not a bloodbath. But maybe the story isn't over yet.
Oh my god, yes! This guy is hardcore and he's a good storyteller. I'm a fan. Way to go, Larius Vero. You're pretty cool. Let's ask about the bad people, huh?
Oh, shit. The bad people are the Kamana Tong. I thought everybody knew that. They're a criminal organization, unfortunately. I don't know who the Kamana Tong are. No one will tell me because I'm an officer. And it's against the code to tell officers things, but people in the Thieves Guild hate the Kamana Tong. I bet if you asked the Thieves Guild, they would cheerfully tell you who the bad people are and where to find them.
Alright, cool. I know where the Thieves Guild is, yo.
In the Empire, the Thieves Guild is old and powerful, but here in Morrowind, the Thieves Guild is young and weak. The old and powerful criminal guild of Morrowind is the Kamana Tong. The Kamana Tong doesn't like the Thieves Guild a lot, and the feeling is mutual. I actually know where both of these guys are, because in my questionings looking for the murderer, I found the Kamana Tong, I think, is at the bottom of the council club, and the Thieves Guild is in that club that's to the southeast of Balmora, not too far from my crib, actually, right next to Nine Toes' place.
Alright then. Tell us about the bloodbath, eh?
The bad people in my story are 5 members of the Kamana Tong. I know they are a scout, a pawnbroker, a savant, a thief, and a smith. And that they are in Belmora. Unfortunately, I don't know their names. But if you can find their names and where to find them, and then maybe my story could have a happy ending with a little bloodbath instead of a little prayer.
Damn. You are a hard motherfucker, Larius Vero. Okay, so we're gonna check this out. This is cool. Oh, can you train me? In Longblade? Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Okay, so we are off. We're off to find the Kamana Tong. I actually know where they are. I don't even know if I want to bother asking.
Go ahead, stranger.
The Thieves Guild or not. Also, we could just recall there, and I think I would like to. It would be nice to see Winesot's face again, so. Assuming that we actually have the mana to be able to do that. Let's get our little recall out. And we don't, so we're just gonna run.
Yeah.
No problemo. It's just this way anyway. Bye, guys! Just waving goodbye. They're like, why is she running backwards? Yeah, that would be kind of weird, actually. Okay, so. Again, off on the road to Balmora. It has been a while since we've traveled this little particular road right here. We're gonna see that guy fishing again. We're gonna wave to him. Yeah, there he is. He just fishes all the time. Hi! I'm like, who is that person? Why are they waving at me? God. Alright, so we know already where the Kamana Tong are. We're gonna go just, at least we know where a member of the Kamana Tong is. We're gonna start with that. Happen to know? Here we go. It should be right here. We're gonna quick save first because you never freaking know with the Kamana Tong, so
this
let's...
one honors us. Please, speak.
Man, people get so excited. Or is he nervous? He might just be nervous. I'm gonna give the murderer's description again. He's like, just a coincidence, I assure you. Ha 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 ha. He's like laughing down the hallway. Is this where it was? I was pretty sure that I found... Oh yeah, here
speak,
we go.
Speak, traveler.
Traveler. Alright, so let's see. I'm gonna ask you about the Kamana Tong, eh?
We're just a society of businessmen. We're Dunmer, and we're proud. We're tired of seeing Morrowind run by outsiders who understand nothing about Morrowind. And we're tired of trying to explain this over and over again to ignorant outlanders.
Oh god, okay, sure. Except that I'm looking for... someone in particular. Actually, if that's all the information that she's gonna give me, I am actually gonna go to the Thieves Guild and check and see... I opened this.
I
opened that closet.
That
don't ask
tell
me why, but I did, so I have to close
place.
That door again. Can't just leave that out in the open there. Okay, so off to the Thieves Guild. Oh, is this like a beggar's cup? Well, you know what? Our piety is ringing loud and clear. We're gonna leave a gold piece for, I guess, whoever needs it. It's sort of like, here. You're rich now, dude who bangs your head on the wall and spits on the rock. I swear he used to be over there flipping that knife. Now he just spits on that rock all day. Dan Murorano. Okay, back to it. We are off to the Thieves Guild, at least as good a guild as it can get. I actually read a book about the Thieves Guild and they were detailing, you know, the Thieves Guilds, they kind of just meet in corner clubs. They
hurry this up, will you?
Don't really have a guild
Khajiit
hall, per se.
Has no time for you.
Actually, Sugar Lips Habasi, you're going to want to make some time for me, honey, because I got some big questions for you. Oh, she can't even answer my questions. Is anybody
Hurry
else
this
here?
Up, can will you?
Aerithor, you definitely look like a freaking thief, so let's see. I would like to ask you about the Kamana Tong, good fellow.
As you probably know, the Kamana Tong is the old criminal syndicate here in Morrowind. And as everyone around here knows, the Thieves Guild is at war with the Kamana Tong. We're the new gang in town, and the Kamana Tong wants us to be dead and gone, gang. If you're looking for the Kamana Tong, their Balmora hangout is in the corner club called the Council Club. Yeah, I just came from there and I didn't...
No worries. I won't hurt you. Ask your question.
Oh my god. That's not unnerving at all. Okay, alright, so back to the Council Club here, and we are gonna check our journal real quick. Okay, so he wants me to go cause a bloodbath in the Kamana Tong. I really hope that this doesn't cause problems for me in the future, but I can't see it not because this is one of the main guilds.
Welcome,
and
friend. I feel as though I should know you.
You probably freaking should by now. I've been by to question you like 10 billion times. All right, so we're gonna quick save one more time.
Make
and
it quick,
I don't
want
to join. Although that might be the quickest way to do it. Can I, what about, do you know anything about Raylan? Oh, she heard that Nine Toes killed Raylan Halalu. Forget that then. Well, this is, a mess. This is a dump, but I've already actually raided all this stuff. Well, not that, because there wasn't anything that I wanted. But I raided everything else.
Those boots are ruined.
I know, right? Jeez, freaking guars, I tell ya. Alright, so here's what we're gonna do. And we're really gonna hope that she doesn't notice us, because she might. We're not
that
sneaky.
There's someone watching me. I can tell.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. We're out of mana. I don't wanna, like, take a mana potion. Aw, man, I used up my Grandmaster pick? Jeez, that had, like, 10 uses. Okay, whatever. So we're gonna take a mana potion. We're also gonna use Onducey's open door. Where's it at? Onducey? There we go, because this is only a level 50. So we can take care of that. Quality, superb. Well, it's kind of a waste, but we'll just have to buy some more mana potions before we go out. And whoosh. Thanks, is this part of the- oh my god, but really, is this all there is? Are there any, like, is there a hidden door back here or something? There's gotta be, right? Eh. Oh. No, nothing under the pillow. I did steal the pillow, though, so now. I'm walking around with, like, a pillow under my arm, like, don't mind me. No, no big deal, just got this pillow. Alright. Oh. Okay, I've tried to walk through every wall. It's a really good thing that I'm invisible, or else this would be really embarrassing. So let's try talking to Madral Theorith again. She says, like, what? I'm gonna ask her about the abolitionists.
These outlanders won't be happy until slavery is outlawed. It's our right to have slaves by law and custom, and it's none of their damn business.
Alright, Wow, she'll actually-
Speak quickly, outlander, or go away.
She can train me in security, that's freaking awesome. I'll just take a couple points of that, no problem. Is that one of my main things? I can't even... No, it's sneak. Sneak is one of my main things. But anyway, so that's good to know. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to ask some other people about the Kamana Tongue. I suppose even though she was like at the basement guarding locked doors, she doesn't actually matter. So let's ask her about the Kamana Tongue. So she says the same thing. Maybe I need to talk to the person who
Make
can
it
join
quick,
them.
Outlander.
Ooh, cool. I can ask her about Cool. Cool is a tiny fishing village on the northern coast of the West Gash. Alright, okay, cool. Literally, cool. So if everybody in the council club is part of the Kamana Tongue and everyone in the council club thinks that Nine Toes did it, then this guy upstairs probably actually did it, or someone in Kamana Tongue. So that was probably a hit on Raylan Halalu. I'm sure that I'll come across that later, but, you know what, I probably need to start asking about the bad people. Is that an option? Bad people? Maybe if I go back to the Thieves Guild, I can ask about the bad people and see what's going on there. Oh my god, it's nighttime. I've been questioning people all day, seriously. First about Raylan Halalu, and then about the Kamana Tongue. I'm on a series of wild goose chases.
Hurry. You have questions?
Yes.
Khajiit has
I'm gonna ask
no
this guy whose life I spared
you.
A long time ago from the Mages Guild. He was selling spells illegally, apparently, and not cutting the Mages Guild in on it, so I was supposed to kill him, and then I was just like, nah, man, just make yourself scarce. And he's like, oh, you mean just stand there? Because apparently that's in his name. Only he stands there. So he's been standing here ever since, and apparently the Mages Guild has never caught on, so it is- Oh, yes, I can! I can ask him about the bad people.
Bad people. If you're looking for specific names from the Kamana Tongue, then you should go talk to the Thieves Guild. I can't afford to get involved. But the Thieves Guild has an interest, and maybe they'd be willing to stick their necks out. You might find someone who will talk to you over at the South Wall Corner Club.
Oh, you mean exactly where I am? Are you actually, did you mean to split? Like, is that
this
what you were trying to do? Okay.
You want questions. Something, friend?
Oh, I love your shorts. Interesting stylistic choice here. We have like a really fancy vest and then like some capris. I ain't hating. You're doing good. You're doing good. Okay, so let's ask him about the bad people. So he asks me to talk to the Thieves Guild as well. Is Juju is not going to help.
What are you?
Chiranir is most definitely like she knows about the bad people. So let's.
Chiranir is listening. Bad people. What do you mean? The Kamana Tong? I don't know about that. Understand? I don't want to know about that. None of my business. I stay out of the council club.
Ask her about the Kamana Tong then. She says the same thing that our wood elf friend said upstairs. So she pretty much nothing. Again, Sugarlips Habasi ain't having it.
If
and
I can help, I will. But don't
look,
take too much
can I ask you
time.
About bad people? Bad people? Yeah, he says that he doesn't know anything about that either. Okay, you know what? You know what we're gonna do? Give you 1,000 gold. All right, you gonna tell me now? Bad people? Oh, yes, that was exactly what we needed to do. All right. If the bad people you're looking for are Kamana Tong and they're in Balmora, then you'll find them at the council club corner club. That's the local Kamana Tong hangout. The scout would be Vadusa Sathrion. Marasa Oren would be the pawnbroker. The thief would be Madrail Theorith. Sover Trandell is Savant. Thanalan Valus would be the smith. Oh no! But if I kill Thanalan Valus, would that ruin that quest for me? Oh well, we gotta do it anyway. This guy's like been lying to me. He's gotta go. He's gotta go. We're on it. We're on it. Oh my god. I think it's gonna be a bloodbath, but let's see if I can like talk my way out of it or figure something out. Maybe I can like threaten them, but they are Kamana Tong, so I just do not know.
May you find me worthy of your attention.
Oh, thank you. I'm here to kill you. It's... I don't know if there's an easier way to say it than that. This is gonna be an awkward situation, but maybe if I kill him at least, you know, maybe I'll get my money back that I paid him earlier, so... This is gonna be weird. I don't feel good about this. It's a crime. I just committed a crime. Oh my god. Oh my god. Here they all are. Oh god. Oh, look at them all. Oh jeez. Oh my god. Oh god. Is this everybody though? There's more than 5 people here. I probably should have gotten them to attack me first. I think this might have been a bad idea. Somebody's getting me with something. Oh man, I didn't want to get the bartender in on this. Look, I'm gonna go like see if I can just like insult some people instead. I really don't want to kill the bartender as well. I have a feeling he's pretty innocent. And plus, there's only 5 people that I need to kill, and there were 6 there.
May you find me.
I'm not trying to just go around murdering people. I am trying to fix things. So I'm gonna ask him about the Kamana Tong, and he doesn't want to tell me shit. So. I asked him about someone in particular. He's like, I mind my own business. Why don't you mind yours, Outlander? All right, Savor. So I believe this is one of the other guys that I got to talk to here. If the bad... A Thieves Guild informant tells me that if the bad people I'm looking for are in the Kamana Tong in Balmora, I'll find them at the Council Club Corner Club. The local Kamana Tong hangout. Larius Farrow mentioned a scout, pawnbroker, savant, thief, and a smith. The scout would be Vadusa Sathrion. Marasa Aran would be the pawnbroker. The thief would be Madral Theris. Silver Trandall is a savant. Okay, so we have Silver Trandall.
I'm waiting.
Vadusa Sathrion. Marasa Aran. But then we have this guy.
Please, have a look around.
Who I don't think is listed, and I feel kind of bad about that. So who's the other person? Is it the lady down here? Maybe I can take her out first. Yes, she is one of the people. Alright, so we're gonna try this first.
Now you die!
My crime has been reported.
This will not go unnoticed. You will be disgraced for this.
Actually, it will go unnoticed because nobody can see me right now. At least that's the idea. So if I'm like sneaking, I guess it probably only works for sneak attacks, but I was trying to do a little bit more crit damage by like crouching down. Again, I feel a little weird about this. I might have to punch the dude at Fort Moonmoth in the face for this, but I guess they are like criminals, right? So let's see what she's got on her. Iron Spark Blade, Shock, Journeyman's Lockpick, eh, why not? Apprentices, ooh, gross, an Apprentices Probe? No way. I am, however, out of lockpicks. She's got some expensive stuff on, some netch leather stuff. I won't take the rest of her shit. So let's go see who else we can attack here.
I can't take anymore.
How are you guys even seeing me? Alright, you know what? Come on, into the hallway. That's what I'm talking about. Get a little strategy here. Again, not something Annalie is known for. She is known for her piety, but not her strategy, and that's just how it goes. And somebody is casting something on me. Let's see what this is. Oh, no, I cast that on myself. It's Chameleon. Never mind. Forget I said anything.
This will not go unnoticed.
Alright, so is this the other guy? Oh, yeah, this guy.
You.
Again, this could be really bad. I'm really glad that we have a quick save before all this. And then we're just gonna split before, and then never come in here again, because otherwise this guy will totally, like, want us to kill him. So let's see if our journal does update whenever we're done with all this. I'm really hoping that it does, but, punching in the butt. Punching in the butt. Actually, on the thigh. There we go. And this guy probably murdered Raylan Halalu as well. So we're just gonna, once he's dead, we're just gonna ignore the axe guy. Let's see. Did that? No, it didn't. It didn't even update that at all. So I'm really not sure what I am supposed to be doing here, but I guess let's grab the, oh my god, he does! He does have a dwarven war axe! I can't believe it! He really did kill Raylan Halalu. Oh my god, and I've murdered all these people, and oh my god. I cannot look at her body. Alright, we're out of here. Nah, dude, you can chillax. Look at him. He's coming after us. But he's not one of the guys that we have to kill, right? At least I don't think so. Is there gonna be a guard, like, right outside of here? Did he come out with me? No? This guy's still banging his head on the wall? Okay, so we're gonna give this a try. Woo! Going to Moonmoth. Gonna talk to that dude and see what we got. Maybe we'll use our scroll of Ictharian flight here. Or Ictharian, not Ictharian. Here we go. Oh dear. Oh, there it goes. Oh my. Oh, we kind of missed our target. Oh my god. Well, this is one way to escape a crime scene. Holy crap. Let's get our feather fall ready, because we know that we're gonna need it. Slow fall, that's what it is. Okay, alright, so we went, like, way far. Holy crap. Alright. Oh, we... That was awkward. Oh my god, where are we? What an adventure. Oh man, we're like out here, there's all kinds of lava everywhere. Look dude, I just killed 5 Kamonaton. You sure you want to fuck with me? I'm serious right now. Alright, here we go. Taking out the Cliffy, Cliff Racer, McCliff Racer the third. And he's down. Do we got another one? No? Look at all that lava. Okay, so where the hell are we? Seriously, where did we fly to? Who knows, man? Oh my god, look, we really, really flew, like, halfway across the world. That's what I'm talking about. That's when it works correctly. Just like in the comments a while ago, I can't quite remember who said it, but they said that That scroll in particular was really dependent on how much weight I had on me. So back to Moonmoth to see if this will work out at all here. I'm just gonna do it again. Screw it. Okay, so here we are back at Fort Moonmoth. Man, I had so many cliff razors on me on the way over, but I didn't want to deal with them, so I kind of just ran. I was hoping I could drag them all the way to Moonmoth and then see an epic monster battle like what's about to happen right now. Look at that. I will pay the gold. Wow, 4,000 gold. Finds a compensation. Dude, I did it for you. I did it for you. Again, if this doesn't work out, I'm just freaking loading because I did something wrong.
Don't stand about. What say
you? So we'll go talk to this guy down here and see what he's got to say. Is this about the work I mentioned? Yeah. Oh my god, we were actually supposed to do that, dude. For real? Like, oh my god, are you serious? Like, we were supposed to kill those guys?
I see. Everything's been taken care of, and remarkably enough, without creating any problems of a legal nature.
Are you freaking kidding me?
You are far more discreet than I had hoped. I'm so glad I found that nice present from the Emperor here. It seems to be a ring, a very nice ring. There was no note with it, I'm afraid. But I'll let the Emperor know you've received it. I'm sure he'll be pleased. And also, from me, because of your exceptional discretion. Take this special volume from my own library with my compliments.
Well, I was really, really, really mad at you. But he gave me a book called The Biography of the Wolf Queen, which I don't have yet. So that's kind of cool. Oh my god, what a wild adventure. What the hell? That was the weirdest thing. So I asked him about the nice present. He's like, do you like it? It's called the Ring of Surroundings. It's useful for sneaking about. I don't know much about it, but I believe it used to belong to a bad person. We don't usually need that sort of thing in the Legion. We're a little more straightforward in our methods. Wink, wink. Usually. Okay, wow, that was insane. Dude, don't even talk to me right now. Like, seriously, I'm out. That was terrible. I had to pay 4,000 gold for your ass. Oh man, is the epic battle still going on? Oh man, I missed it again! Alright, well, thank you so much for watching. What a weird freaking quest. Seriously. That was bizarre. I feel like my reputation was a little bit tarnished, but it's probably back at the top now. Let's see, are we like wanted or anything? Damn, 4,000 gold! Holy crap. I wonder if I'm gonna get kicked out of any of my- Oh shit, I wonder if I'm gonna get kicked out of the temple. Well, here's hoping that we don't. If we do, maybe we can go on a pilgrimage again. That was fun the first time. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and
go ahead,
will-
stranger.
Wow, he's so huge. I will see you next time.